Okay, so before we continue too much further, I want to test the radios B plus with the circuit the way it is. So let's do that
very quickly here.
Excuse me, it was all the way up. Good. It's all the way down now. There we go. Oh. Okay. I'm not going to get anywhere with the tube not plugged in here. Okay. Let's... Let's give that a try. There we go. There. Only 87 there. Same things here and here. Okay, we give it full voltage. What's going on with this diode here? What? Something funny about that, eh? I'm reading across this diode that is, that's the voltages. Double checking again. 135. Well, 130. 95. Okay. So, I think it's just a matter of just cutting all these wires. I don't think it's too complicated. This guy. Well, let's see if it's just tacked in there or because this middle post here, I don't think it has anything else on it, but just got not much wire on that, eh? Now, some connections you can do that with. But when you're talking about the connections that might get a little warm, that's maybe not the best place to do it. And these will get a little warm because this resistor's here, and you really want to get these kind of wrapped on better. Let's check. There's probably nothing wrong with it at all. But I've got some better ones here, I think. Let's see what I got here. A 450 volt one, that's a little big. Yeah, all the rest of them are 450 volt capacitors. I don't want to use those, that doesn't make a lot of sense there. These will work great. Okay. Why not? Camera. It just won't play nicely.
There we go.
Better. To maximize heat transfer from my soldering iron. Oh boy, just a momentary lap. I'm left wondering about them too. Now, This is exposed to some interesting things here. Take a look at. So let's do that. Three-dimensional scale. I can see a couple of pretty new-looking capacitors, rather. And that resistor, the gray, red, brown one, that looks pretty darn new. 1500 watt, that's the one we talked about already. There's a, of course, an old resistor here. And these dog bone resistors, which have a peculiarly new look to them. Can I say that? Whereas these ones, they look really old. Those resistors and capacitor combination. Very distinct. There's a dark one. There it is there. It just shoots right to the right to a ground connection. Right over here. So that's what the black one does. Another colored one here is a greenish one. Well, it's very green under here. And it goes over to this interesting spot here. I don't know what that is in the radio. Now the other wires coming in are these three kind of goldish ones here. This one looks like it's got a bit of a pattern to it. I think it would be this one. Oh, that's bringing up the B plus. But this is where it says to grid. And there's no way that this connection is off of one of these tubes. So wait a minute. Then, where is that point and where is that wire? I'm asking, I guess it's not rhetoric. What's that, red, brown, something like that? Red, brown, yellow. Red, brown. I have to think about that. Okay, so let's give the radio a test after we've replaced those guys. Okay, so put on the lights, get the voltmeter ready. Fine. Anytime you fool around, anytime I fool around with the ...1086, I think that's pretty similar to what it was last time. Let's put it on full power. Same readings. Yeah, I'm exactly the same. 134. ...103. 30 volts falling across the resistor. That's that. There we go.